Cause girls like you run around with guys like me till sundown. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Girls like you love fun and yeah, me do what I want. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah.
You know, viewers, come back. It's breakfast, lunchtime. So I thought, well, it's about nearly 12 o'clock, but I haven't had breakfast, so it's a kind of a breakfast lunch, I suppose. But I've got the muesli, the healthy stuff, muesli, fruit, yogurt, skim milk, the Happy Days shake, which I don't know what's in it, but apparently it's healthy for you, and the unhealthy toast. But it's whole grain, it's whole grain. So I'll get stuck into it. And probably there's a market on today, probably have a look around the market and then head down the beach for a bit of sun. And there may be a couple of schooners. So I'll see you after I eat this. Catch. So on a scale of 1 to 10, I'd give that breakfast, the muesli and the toast, fairly standard. I'll give it about an 8.5 out of 10. It was about $25 or something like that, so it's not cheap, but nothing's too cheap up here. But yeah, not a bad food. It's called the Banaroma Cafe. Give it a passing by. It's just opposite the Hervey Bay Sailing Club. Anyway, we'll move on. A bit of a market going down here on the foreshore. Nothing big, pretty small actually. Bit of music over there, some kids belting out the tunes.
Wash your face and hair. Rid me of my problems. But do all that you can.
It's quite relaxed kind of market. Like I said, not too much here, but always worth a bit of a look. Just selling some knickknacks. One thing I'm going to I'll check this joint up over here. It's like a kind of a Vietnam vet. Pretty cool flags. Some badges and
I'm like, yeah, made whips there. Like I said, small market, not worth a worth a look, but I'm heading to the beach, I think. Back to get my towel and my togs and heading down to the beach. It's a bit of a pastime for Aussies, especially people that are retired or even not retired, is to sell up and travel around Australia with a van or a setup like this is quite good. Camper vans, caravans, people will just pack up and drive around Australia for about 6 months or whatever. And they can stay in caravan parks like this, right on the water, for powered sites. I don't know how much it costs, but it's a cheap way to get around. Mostly the people have got the four-wheel drives to tow their vans around, and they might stay here for a few weeks before they move on to the next place. It's not a bad idea. Something that I'll be looking at down the track, I suppose. But I do tend to go to Thailand a lot. So, that's kind of my famous pastime anyway. But, different kind of holiday. It's a pretty good lifestyle. Some of these vans cost a lot of money, and some people sell their house to buy their van, and that'll become their home. Anyway, I'm going to use their toilets because I'm busting. I might have to have a go for a bit of a dip, I think. It's hit about 30 degrees up here. So it's looking pretty calm. Give it a go. Anyway, it's time for a beer. And this is not a bad joint, this Torquay Hotel. I've been here a couple of times. Not a bad boozer. I think 570 for a schooner, which is not too bad. It's more, a bit more expensive in Melbourne. Anyway, it's pretty open up. They open up at the front there on a nice day. Let's go grab a beer. Just drinking usually 4X gold at the moment. I was having a bit of that northern stuff. It's not too bad. But got the tap. Do you want to get on the punt? But I'm not going to get on the punt. I'm just going to have a beer. Can I just get a schooner of 4X gold, please? $5.70, yeah?
560.
And the way you're gonna save me.
You're on camera,
right?
Smile.
So I went out there and got the Maris car was doing it.
Yeah.
I got kept the charge. Right
there, and I said, this
goes. So 560. Not too bad. Want a seat out here? This will do me in the sun for a while. Cheers. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that minor 4X gold. Pretty standard beer. But like it's a mid-strength. And if you're not planning on getting too off your head, too off your nutter, 4X gold does the trick. But a couple of beers here will do me just fine, just nicely. Here we are. I've just driven down from Hervey Bay down to Noosa, and it's packed. It's on a Sunday. I remember last time I was here a few years ago, it was real busy. It's a real busy place, Noosa Heads. Probably 12 months of the year. But these are the kind of places you can end up staying in. They're everywhere. It's a bit of a money kind of place, you know. You've got to have a bit of money to kind of play here if you want, or live here, or stay here. But I just finally found a car park, and we're going to head down to the beach. This is kind of south of Noosa. I'm on my way to I'm on my way to Coolum. And there's been some fires down that way, so there may be a couple of detours, but we'll find out when we go down there. But I just thought I'd stop over. Stop over and check out the beach at Noosa Heads. For you people that haven't been here before, like I said, I've been here a few years ago with my son, was about 7 or 8 years ago. Actually, not with my son, with my daughter, my wife. That's how long it was. Anyway, here we are. Just walking down the steps now to... It's a bit of a surf spot. You'll see a few surfers out here. It's an absolute brilliant day. I'll take my thongs off. And here we go. Like I said, this is just south of Noosa. The CBD down there was ridiculous. Like, there was no car spots. It was just bumper to bumper. So I've just driven a bit south. And here we are. Looks pretty good. There's a couple of surfers out there. Got a fisherman here. Doing a bit of surf fishing. We've got lifesavers up that way. The water looks beautiful. And it's not too cold either. It's pretty warm. Probably worth a bit of a dip, I reckon. That looks perfect. Absolute perfect. There'll be a few rips here too. And that's why they suggest or they make you try and swim between the flags, because that's where the lifesavers are. So we head down this way a little bit, towards the flags. Up there you can see the little lifesavers, little hut up there. They can, got a bit of height there, they can look over the water. Obviously, like I said, there'll be a few rips here. That was about 2 hours drive from Hervey Bay. Not a bad drive. Heaps of caravans on the road, as you probably would expect around this area. Got a few surfies out there. But I'm not too far from Coolum, so I could suggest, I just thought I'd check the Noosa Beach out, and I reckon I'll head down to Coolum, and I've booked a hotel there on hotel.com, a hotel on the beach there with a beach view, so that'll be interesting to have a look at. And I think it's only less than half an hour from here, so we'll have a quick look down around this beach. Obviously, this is where the flags are. Swim within the flags, especially in Australia. Got a lot of different currents in the water. And you can be swept out pretty easily. Get caught in a rip. And a lot of people don't even know about rips and don't know how to swim out of a rip, and they get caught up in them and they panic and they end up drowning. So that's why they suggest, or they want you to swim between the flags. As you can see, it's not a big space there, but that's where the safe place to swim is. Obviously, you know, you'll get people down here swimming at their own peril.
Yeah, the water's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I think it's about the 14th or 15th of September. And it's an absolute wonderful day. So I'll leave it there, guys. It's been a good trip so far, you know. Checked out a few places, and I've got a few other places to check out. So keep on tuning in. Press that subscribe button and ring the bell. Thanks for being involved, and I hope you like the vlog. And I'll catch us later from Noosa Heads. Jergun, Swadi Cup, Kopkum Cup.